Next, we're going to look at some output options and different ways to do output in MATLAB. So just like there's a fancy way to ask for information, there's also a fancy way to explain it. So say that I wanted to display the numbers 1 through 5. Okay, so let's talk about output options. So if I have the numbers 1 through 5, come on. Let me do CLC clear to get started. So I've got the numbers 1 through 5. Now, if I want, I can just not suppress it and it'll be fine. By fine, I mean, partial credit fine, but maybe like 5% partial credit fine. Generally, this is really bad. Just think about all the programs that you use. They don't show you all the intermediate output. So whenever I go in here, if I have x is equal to blah, 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 as the user, that's really confusing because you might think, what is this x thing? Why are you showing this to me? So we do want to be careful about showing this kind of stuff to the user. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to suppress that output. The x is still there. Now what I can do is I can use a comment called disp. And that displays the value of x without actually putting the x on there. On top of that, I can use a string and say something like, these are the values of x. So I have to do the open parentheses, open little, whatever you call those things. I always forget apostrophes. These are the values of x. It doesn't really matter whatever you do, but there you go. So these are the values of x. Now from the user's perspective, would you rather see x equals 1 through 5, kind of yucky, or these are the values of x? And I'm an engineer, I want to see the data, sure. But most people aren't engineers. Only cool people get to be engineers. And so therefore, these are the values of x. Kind of make sense? Kind of see what's going on? All right. So these are the values of x. X. Save. Okay, so that's one kind of display. Let's see what other kind of displays do we have. Yay. Okay. So I'm going to copy these over. More. CLC clear. So say I have two separate strings, and I'm going to comment this first one out. I'm going to comment this first one out. So I can go with display string 1, and I can display string 2, and I get, I think that's the right quote, whatever, something good enough. So we've got our two display strings, and I can combine those into one display string. So I can do the first one and the second one, or if I want to do the first and the second one together, I need to basically create a matrix. So this is kind of what we were doing with the matrix where we had A and then the B and the B transpose and they were all inside the same matrix. Really what we're doing is we're taking the matrix, because remember we kind of mentioned that string is a 1 by 20 matrix, and I'm putting next to it a 1 by 32 matrix. So I have a 1 by 20 matrix here, and then a space, and a 1 by 32 matrix. Here, not really a space, I just put a space in. I could just as easily have put in a comma. So I have the first one, and then I have the 1 by 20, and then when I run that, I get the whole thing. Now it's pretty common for students to initially forget to put in that special space. I put in the space. If I don't put in the space, even if you put a space here, it's not doing that, because what it's doing is it's taking this little matrix and this little matrix and putting them right next to each other. So I could put the space here if I want, and it'll work. But look how that whenever I display the string by itself, that it's indented one. It's indented one because I gave it one space. Space, space, space. Now it's indented a whole bunch of spaces. So hopefully this kind of helps you to get the idea that whenever I'm doing this concatenation, this is called concatenation. When I'm doing this concatenation, really what I'm doing is I'm taking this matrix, and then I'm putting the next matrix really right next to it. It might help to think about it like 1 through 5, or 1 through 2, 1 through 3, whatever, and 4 through 5. If I wanted to display, let me pull these down here. If I wanted to display the numbers 1 through 5, I could just as easily go x and y, okay? And that's gonna get me the same kind of thing. Suppress, suppress. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see how that's just taking this first set of guys and this second set of guys and putting them right next to each other. Now it automatically spaces them because they are matrices, and not just a long set of characters, but it's still the same idea that I couldn't just say display X and Y like that because I would get an error. I actually have to put those brackets around because what I'm doing is I'm creating a new matrix and I'm displaying it. So just as simply, I could also say create a new matrix and display that new matrix. And that would work. So I could create a new matrix based on X and Y and display it. Similarly, I could create message string 1, string 2. I could create that and then display the message itself. And I'll still get the same thing. If I wanted, I could, let me fix that because it's bothering me. So if I do this, I get it. Now, if I wanted, I could display message, message, message. And then I've just created another matrix made out of the previous matrix. You really want to go crazy? If you can understand what the output that's going to be. Woohoo! So I transposed the message and I displayed it three times. Despite all my rage. There you go. Perfect? Makes sense? Kind of? Got it? Alright. So basically the idea is that whenever I put these together, I can, anytime I want to combine like text and text, or text and anything else, and we'll talk about the anything else in a minute, but I need to, if I'm going to use the display statement, I need to keep things inside those brackets. Yes? Good. Alright. So back to Hot Pockets. No, this is not called back to Hot Pockets. This is called combining text and numbers. Yay! Alright. So let's say I'm going to ask my user about Hot Pockets. So X equals input. So see if you can write, I'm sort of writing this for you. Ask the user how many Hot Pockets they had for breakfast. Hot Pocket. Alright. Ask the user how many Hot Pockets they had for breakfast. So see if you can do that. Then if you're super awesome, then display the statement like you ate blah blah, can't spell, blah blah Hot Pockets, and just display it right back to them. All right. So ideally what you should try to do is pause it and at least get the first part of the ask the user part. And of course I can't make you, but you should totally do it because it'd be awesome. All right. So I want to ask the user how many Hot Pockets they had for breakfast. Input, how many Hot Pockets? Okay. It's common for students to forget to put the X in there, and honestly, it's not that it doesn't work, but it doesn't work because it doesn't actually store the information. See how it just says that the answer is 6? That's like on my calculator when I have those little answers that just, you know, scroll by, and once they're gone, they're kind of gone forever. This is the same thing. So just typing the input statement by itself, students sometimes also do this, which just is beyond me. All it's saying is that I've defined a variable called input that says how many Hot Pockets. So that's really weird. Don't do that. Okay, input is a function name. Remember we talked about how you can overwrite function names? Yeah, so I just overwrote the input function with how many Hot Pockets, which is just not a good thing. So X equals how many Hot Pockets? And I don't like that, so I'm going to fix that so it looks better. How many Hot Pockets? 5 Hot Pockets. Also, I don't like actually seeing it, the X equals 5 thing, so I do want to suppress the output. So ultimately, you should have code that looks something like that. How many Hot Pockets? 5. Alright, and you're like, okay, so if I'm going to do this, I ate how many Hot Pockets? String 1, you ate. And then blah, and then Hot Pockets. Oh, come on, girl. Like that. You ate blah Hot Pockets. You're like, okay, I can do this. Display. String 1, you ate X. String 2. Kind of looks like a times, but it's not, just the number X. And you get an error. You're like, man, this is stupid. Wait, no, this isn't stupid. I remember I'm supposed to put it into brackets because I put it into brackets to indicate that I have concatenated these matrices. I've combined these matrices. All right, Achoo! How many hot pockets? 5. You ate hot pockets. All right. I did eat hot pockets, but how many did I eat? Thanks for that. Let's change the number. So let's say 99 hot pockets or 50 hot pockets. Okay, so now things I ate 2. That's, I guess, a progress. If I ate 99 hot pockets, I ate chop pockets. That doesn't make any sense. Do you remember what's going on? Do you have any theories? Okay, so let's go back. And we talked a minute ago about our ASCII table. So I'm going to say this again. Now you really have to know it. Check out the ASCII table. So that's ASCII table. So I'm going to go Google my ASCII table. Except I can't spell, but that's all right, because Google knows I can't spell. There we go. There's my thingy, whatever. So whenever I said that I ate 99 hot pockets, it came back as a C. Now you see where that C is coming from? So if I said that I ate 70 hot pockets, I would expect it to say I ate the hot pockets. So let's try it and see. 70. Yep, I ate hot pockets. Those don't sound very appealing, so don't do that. All right, so what we need to do is we have to tell MATLAB, because what MATLAB's doing is it's thinking, well, you gave me string, and you gave me string, so this must be a string too. You just must be using, you know, the ASCII table. You're like, why would I do that? And MATLAB's, because you're supposed to be a programmer. You're like, but I'm not. I'm just trying to get stuff that works and solve problems. But no, you're a programmer now. So what I have to do is I have to tell MATLAB, take that number and turn it to a string. And this is why I love MATLAB. Look how amazing. Like, I can just look at that function and know what it does. num2String. It turns a number to a string. I'm going to say that again. num2String turns a number to a string. So now if I say I ate 70 hot pockets, it says I ate 70 hot pockets. Like, but it's not spaced out. You're right, it's not spaced out. Why isn't it spaced out? Well, mine isn't spaced out. Maybe you major is right. But you should make your spaced out. So again, throughout all of this, if you're just watching and being like, I'm just going to pick it up, that's not going to happen. You need to be actively learning and actively doing stuff. You ate space hot pockets. 77. All right, close. So where does the other space need to go? Hot pockets. Chunk. I ate 77 hot pockets. Got it? All right, now if you wanted, you don't have to say string 1, string 2. You could actually just go straight in here and say you ate num to string x hot pockets. And that should work. It's going to give me the same answer. So I don't have to use variables. I can't actually put an input statement in there, I don't think. I think that'll freak it out. But anyway, this is kind of fun. You ate blah hot pockets, and it works. Don't you just love it when MATLAB stuff works? All right, this is kind of fun. So over in the notes, I want you to run the cell. You just go in here and you hit run section. And it says, hi there, I'm your MATLAB program. Who are you? I am Chicken Pickle Monkey. Hi, I am Chicken Pickle Monkey. Computers are very useful. You'll use them a lot in college. Good luck in your studies. Bye. Okay, so basically, the point of this is that I can take input from the user and I can talk to my computer. So I'm gonna do a CLC and clear it out. And I'm gonna run it again. It's gonna say, I am Bugaboo. Chocobo. Hi, Chocobo, computers are very useful. Goodbye. And you're like, yay, the computer's talking to me. Like the pause, I think the pause is important for effect. What's kind of fun is to go to this website here, or just in general, Google Eliza, and come over here. So these came out like in the 70s, I think. It's a Rogerian psychotherapist person, which is basically the idea that you ask questions, or it's like the psychiatrist that just takes what you just said and asks it back to you. So you're like, how may I help you? And you can say, I really love MATLAB. It's like, ah, please continue. You're like, okay. Programming makes me happy inside. What does that suggest to you? I think maybe it's because of my childhood. Why the uncertain tone? I'm not certain. How long have you been not certain? Most of my life. That's insightful. Thank you. Oh? Yes, I never thought of that before. Anyway, isn't it like... Yes, I just said that. Anyway, this is really fun. So I think there were some experiments back in the 70s or something. You can go read about it if you want. But basically, they, I think they set this up and they put people in front of computer screens and people like sat there for hours because they thought they were actually talking to a person. And yes, it's really, really neat. So there's other chatbots as well, but Eliza's kind of like the famous one, I think. You can Google it. It's like Eliza Brogerian, the computer therapist. Yeah. So she was famous. Yeah. Do 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 do. Perhaps your plans have something to do with this. Startlingly human-like interaction, and my mother hates me. Who else in your family hates you? Anyway, it's just kind of a fun little whatever you call it. Application of input and output and just something kind of fun to play with in general.